Area for quadrilaterals. We have around 5 types of quadrilateral here. Okay, we'll make use of area of triangle formula in order to find this area of quadrilateral, and we make use of concept called as the in a parallelogram or rectangle, the diagonals bisect each other. That is, they divide the length of diagonals into equal halves. We make use of those concepts in order to find this area and perimeter for quadrilaterals. Okay, take this parallelogram. For in order to find its perimeter, perimeter is very simple, sum of all outer boundaries, that is a plus b plus a plus b. So here perimeter is equal to 2 into a plus b, very easy. Now in order to find this parallelogram here, what we will do is we will divide into 2 equal triangles here. So now we know that this is base for this, and we have to know what the height, exact perpendicular height. Here it is slant height. So in order to make use of find area of triangle here, just draw a parallel line here, which is height h. Try a perpendicular line h here. Now what is the area of this triangle now? This triangle, first of triangle, it is nothing but area of quadrilateral, sorry, area of parallel is equal to, for first half, it is half into a into this height h. Okay, we know in a parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. So for this also, if you take this as a side, again this is your height h for this triangle. Again this plus half into a into h. This is half, this is half too, it becomes a into h, where a is base of parallelogram, h is height of parallelogram. Fine. For rectangle, already we have found out this area of this rectangle. It is a plus b plus a plus b. It is equal to 2 into a plus b. For area of triangle, I have explained the concept, stick of length a and dragging this parallel to b times. Or you can do with the concept of area of triangle also here. So divide this into equal halves. Now for this equal, this half it is half into AB. This is half into AB. So completely area of rectangle is equal to A into B here. Okay. Now go for square. What is perimeter for square? Perimeter is equal to A plus A plus A plus A. It is equal to 4A here. Now in order to find area for the square, again divide into equal halves here. For this first half is, what is area? This area of the square is, first one is half A square. This is half A square. Completely it is A square. Now come for rhombus here. What is perimeter for rhombus? As sides are same, the perimeter is equal to a plus a plus a plus a, which is equal to 4a here. So in order to find this area, diagonal of d1 length and this diagonal of d2 length. Fine, we know in rhombus diagonals bisect each other. That means it is divided into d1 by 2. This is this side is again d1 by 2, and for this diagonal it is d2 by 2. This is d2 by 2. So now, if you take one part like this, it looks like this. This is d1 by 2, this is d2 by 2. Fine. Now, like this, how many we have? 1, 2, 3, 4 we have. So, how to find area? Half into d1, d2 by 2, d2 by 2. You see, this formula is half into d1 by d2 into d2 by 2. Now, how many we have for the numbers? 4. So, area of rhombus is equal to 4 into half into d1. D2 by 4, 4 would get cancelled. Answer is half into D1 into D2. Okay, so this is for rhombus. Again, for a trapezium, if you divide this trapezium into, divide this trapezium like this. Now, again, this is one triangle, this is second triangle here. Okay, now draw a line whose height is H here. So again, here also draw a line whose height is H here. So for this triangle, it is half into A into H. For this triangle, it is half into b into h, because these are not same. So if you take half h common, it becomes half into a plus b into h. So it is nothing but half into sum of parallel sides into height between these parallel sides. So this is called as half into sum of parallel sides into distance between parallel sides. Like this, we can call it as. So no need to by heart this. Just make use of the concept of area of triangle. Formulas for this. Okay. Now let's find area for regular polygon here. What is regular polygon means? Regular polygon is where all sides are equal and all angles are equal. Then only we call it as regular polygon. So we are finding formula only for regular polygon here. So in order to give general formula for any sides like 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So let me explain with 6 sides. Then I use formula for n sides. Okay. Now see, I have taken example as hexagon here, whose sides are 6 sides and angles are 6 here. Now, you know, for a regular hexagon, okay, total series, which is equal to 720 degrees for 6 sides. Okay, now for each side, it is 20 divided by 6 here. So it is divided for these 6 sides. So it becomes here 120 degrees. This has 120 degrees for each side. Now, if you divide an interval by side, it becomes 60 degrees here. So this complete 120. So this side 60, this side 60. Fine. Now, I have divided into 6 equal triangles for hexagon. So if I draw here 1, this is 1 triangle, 2nd triangle, 3rd triangle, 4th triangle, 5th triangle, 6th triangle. So complete we have 6 triangles here. 6 equal triangles here. So if you find area of triangle for remaining 6, you can make it to 6 times here. So this is the approach we will do it for regular polygons here. So we know if this is 60, it looks like an equal triangle here. So do not directly find height here and apply this base. By that you can find your area of equal formula type. So that is here I apply sine 60 means, so opposite side divided by hypotenuse. Here hypotenuse I have taken as A. Okay, because this is also equilateral triangle, see the side is again A here. This is A, this is A, this is A. So this is A here. So what is this height here? X is equal to A into sin 60 here. Okay, now not to find area of triangle, be half into base into height, right? So half into base is A here. Again, this height is nothing but A sin 60 here. It becomes half A square by 2 sin 60 here. So if you apply sin 60 value here, it becomes root 3 by 2. Then it becomes 3 root 3 by 2 a square. So this is for hexagon. Normally, if it is not hexagon, if it is of n polygon, that is 6, 7, 8, 9, what we have to find? First, find this angle. How to find this? So, and how to find this height? Height x is find with the help of a into sin 60 here. How you got sin 60 here? 2 pi, that is 360 degrees divided by n, will give you this 60 degrees here. So, I have written formula like this. For n sides, it is a into sin 2 pi by n. If it is case of 6 here, substitute 6 here, it is 360 divided by 6, it becomes 60 here, a sin 60, fine. Now, once this x is been found out, and substitute this x in the general formula like here. Okay, so that is in short form, n is for n sides, and half into a is for base, and height is about a sin 2 pi by n. So, for area of regular polygon is n by 2 a square sin 2 pi n. This is applicable for all the polygons for n side greater than 5. Let's find area and perimeter for a circle here. We know this is a circle and total angle in a circle is 360 degrees. If I mention in degrees, it is 360 degrees. Total angle in a circle is 60 degrees. If I want to measure in radians, units is radians, then it takes 2 pi radians here. 2 pi radians. It is 360 degrees is equal to 2 pi radians. Always, this is in degrees, this is in radians. So, how to identify this? So, this is a degree for something. If there is no degree, then by default, it is called as a radians. If degree is mentioned, it is equal to 360 degrees. So, that is, finally here, 2 pi is equal to 360 degrees here. What about pi? Pi is equal to 180 degrees here. So if you find the value of pi in radians, is pi is equal to 22 by 7. We have separate proof for this and we don't require now. So always remember 2 pi radians is equal to 360 degrees here. Now let's find length arc, this arc, length of this arc. Formula length of arc is equal to L square r theta, but how to write that formula? Okay, so let me take, what is the theta here, angle between these two radiuses. Now, let me take this angle is very small angle, and the distance from this line to this line is called length. We can also call it arc here. Arc is nothing but part of circle. So, we call it as length of arc. Now, if I take parallel like this, so it looks like this, say here like this. Normally, this is arc L. So, I'll approximate to a straight line here, you have to apply this trigonometry concept here. So, this L is approximated here to L here. Now, this is your theta. Okay? This is your R. Now, if I apply here, tan theta is equal to what happens here? Tan theta is equal to opposite side L by adjacent side R. Now, as this is approximated, so here tan theta is approximated to theta here. because tan is an increase function, as 0 increases, theta value increases. So I can, for very infinitely, very small value, this tan theta can be approximated to theta here. Similarly, this length is approximated to L here. If you observe it here, this length of this arc is equal to arc theta here. If theta is not given in degrees, then it is radians. So what if I only this length is called as arc theta here. Understood? Now, what is the perimeter? Perimeter is nothing but sum of all this lengths. So if this is, this arc length is L here, and throughout this towards how many degrees is called as perimeter of this circle, or circumference of the circle. Circumference is nothing but outer edge of the circle. Now, if you imagine just for this one angle, it is, so L is equal to R theta, means in place of theta you have to substitute 1 here, R. If theta is only 1 degrees, it is 1 degrees into R. If it is for 30 degrees, it is 30 degrees into R. If it is for complete 30 degrees, it is, because for perimeter it has to cover complete thing, so it has to be R into 30 degrees. So if I want to mention in radians here, what is the theta value here? 2 pi. So from here, perimeter is equal to, in substitute of theta, you have to substitute 2 pi here, it is equal to 2 pi R. That is also circumference of circle is equal to 2 pi R is a formula in radians. Got it? Let's find area of circle here. So in order to find circle, I'll divide the circle into 4 equal parts. So this is called 1 quarter, 2nd quarter, 3rd quarter, 4th quarter. I'll try to find area of 1st quarter here, and I'll try to multiply it into 4 times for area of circle here. Now, this is 1st quarter. So this is R radius, and in order to find length of this R, we know L is equal to R theta formula. And it is for only 1 quarter, this has to be made 24 pi R divided by 4 here. So 2 pi R divided by 4 here. Now, we know for a triangle here, if you treat it as a triangle, the area of triangle is half into base into height here. So here base is R. So here height is, normally you have to take this, but here this is looks somewhat different. So if we approximate this length as your height here, so for this triangle, so it becomes half into R into, this R into 2 pi by 4. So if you do calculation, it becomes half, this gets cancelled, R square pi by 4. Now how many, like this quarters you have, 4 quarters. So 4 into pi R square by 4, 4 will get cancelled, area of square is pi R square, area of circle is pi R square. If it is only for, it is a third half circle, semi means half, half means half circle is like this. Now, instead of taking 4 quarters, you have to take only 2 quarters here. It becomes 2 into pi r square by 4, it gets pi r square by 2, where r is the radius. Got it? So, this is an approximation process. Normally, this process we don't follow for finding area of a circle. Just, I am telling you how to find this area of circle in an approximation process. This is not exact position, but this is a like approximation. If I diameter is but largest caught inside a circle. If I want to find what is the length of this diameter, it is R plus R, 2R, part of this part, only this part, if I want to find out for this, area of this R, area of this R. So first, you have to find this theta angle, totally is nothing but 2 theta is equal to 360 degrees. If this is 60 degrees, you have to divide this both sides with, so if it is 2 pi is equal to 360 degrees, now to become 60 degrees here, you have to divide 60 here. So the area of this, formed by this R, this area. We know for complete circle for 2 pi radians or 30 degrees, the area of circle formula is pi r square. In order to find for 1 degree, it will be pi r square divided by 30 degrees, because it has to divide with the 30 degrees for 1 degree. Now, if there is angle theta, for 1 degree it is like this. If there is a theta times, means this formula becomes theta times here. If it is for 60 degrees, it will be pi r square by 30 degrees into 60 degrees. Fine? So, area of this AOB is equal to whatever is the angle theta, theta is equal to pi r square theta divided by 30 degrees. This is the formula for area of sector found by length of arc AB. Let's have some problems on this. Okay, they are given if area of right angle triangle is 40 square centimeters, if perpendicular is equal to 10 centimeters, find its base. Okay, they are given area, they are given perpendicular, perpendicular is nothing but height, and they want base here. So, substitute here 40 to area is equal to half into base, base into height is 10 here. So, if you substitute here, B is equal to 84 divided by 10, base is equal to 8.4 centimeters here. So, it is very easy now. Okay, next, a wheel means it looks like a circle here. Evin makes 2000 revolutions in covering a distance of 88 kilometers, 5 minutes of speed. So it made 22 revolutions. Revolutions means it is rotating, rotating. So rotating means how, if it rotates one time, it covers its circumference of the circle distance. Because just take this point, if we move here, for this point to come again to this point, so it covers this length here. So it is nothing but circumference, which is formula is equal to 2 pi r. So how many revolutions it has made like this? It has made 2000. So and it covered how much distance it covered? It will cover 88 kilometers. Find r here. Okay, so which is r is equal to 88. Okay, divided by 2000 into 2 into 5 is 22 by 7 into 22 by 7. So 24 so kilometers. So make it in meters, because r is equal to 7 meters here. Okay, now find area of triangle whose sides are 26 cm, 28 cm, 30 cm. By looking the sides value, because it looks like a scalar triangle here. If all sides are same, it is equal triangle. If 22 sides are same, it is isosceles triangle. If all three are different, it is scalar triangle. Scalar triangle means first we have to find perimeter. Perimeter is equal to 2s is equal to 26 plus 28 plus 30, which is equal to 84. With this half semi perimeter has to find out, which is equal to 42. And this is Heron's formula, okay, which is equal to S into substitute those values in the place of S and S minus C, will get this 336 square centimeters. This is the way you have to. So there is one more question like this. They have given difference between two parallel sides of a trapezium is 8 centimeters. So we know this parallel size lengths are different. And they given the difference between this and this is 8 centimeters. So if I take this as a larger parallel side, A minus B is equal to 8 centimeters. Now, the parallel, the perpendicular distance between them is 30. This is the perpendicular distance is nothing but height. The height they are given as 38 centimeters. Area of trapezium is equal to 950 centimeters square. So, and find the length of each parallel side. Okay, we know the area of trapezium is equal to half into sum of parallel sides into height. So that is nothing but if you substitute here, 38, A plus B is equal to 29, and you substitute this 29 into any one of this equation, you will get B value as 21 centimeters. So whenever you are solving these menstruation problems, after each line, try to write conclusion from each line. Like this, the difference between two parallel sides of trapezium is 8 cm, like this, write it here, A minus B is equal to 80. And for this way, the perpendicular distance between them is 38 cm, height is equal to 38 cm like this. And if the area of trapezium is equal to like this, means half into A plus. So write those values in smaller values. Don't read everything and try to decode it. So after each line, try to write what is the inference of that line, then for you to understand the question. Fine?
Please subscribe to my channel, Connecting Minds, and please share link with your friends. Jai Hind.